In continuation of the second part of lecture number 3, we have discussed some basic terminologies which are used in the determination of irrigation water requirement and its measurement. Like in second part, we have discussed the types of soil, preparation of land for irrigation, classes and availability of soil water, limiting soil moisture conditions, depth and frequency of irrigation. Now we have some other basic terminologies used in the irrigation water requirement and its measurement. So we have the crop period. Okay, actually we have to provide the sufficient water and to the agricultural land throughout the crop season. Okay, so we have different periods. One is the crop period. So the crop period is the period is the time in days dead crops takes from the instance of its sowing to its harvesting. Okay, mean when you harvest the crops. Okay, so from that time, from that date, from that day up to the date of harvesting, that is called the crop period. But or the time required by a crop from the time of sowing to the time of harvesting. Okay, mean suppose if you plant a crop at the 1st January and harvest it at 30th June, then the crop period will be approximately 180 days. Okay, but sometime before the sowing, we are preparing the land for the agricultural crops. Okay, so sometime before the sowing, we are applying the irrigation. So actually we are dealing with irrigation, so we have to know about the total crop period, that when you have to apply the first irrigation, mean either it is after sowing or it is before sowing. So we are not concerned with the date of sowing, but we are concerned with the application of first irrigation. And also we are not concerned with the date of harvesting, but we are concerned with the date of the last irrigation. So we have to design that how much water is utilized by the crops throughout its season. So the water utilization will be actually from the first irrigation into last irrigation. So for that purposes, we have another term which is called the base period. So base period for a crop refers to the whole period of cultivation from the time when irrigation water is first issued for preparation of the land for planting to the last irrigation. Okay, mean the days between the first irrigation and last irrigation, that is called the base period. For some typical crops, the average base periods are, for example, for wheat that is 120 days, for sugarcane that is 360, for cotton that is 200, for rice that is 120. So for example, for rice, before sowing, before the plantation, when we are preparing the land, then we have to apply the irrigation. So the days from first irrigation to last irrigation, that is termed as the base period, and that is conveniently represented by D, and the unit of it will be days. Okay, then we have another period. See, sometime when we sow the crops at the initial stages. Okay, so that is called the initial stage. Yeah, we can say that is called the maturing stage. So at the maturing stage, some more water are required due to the normal requirement. Okay, so crops need maximum water at the maturing stage, at the early stages, at the first watering. So the depth of such water is called the core water, and the number of days to apply such water is called the core period. Okay, so in continuation of the second part, in which we have discussed the an example, okay, which we have discussed the an example in which there was the crop water utilization in one irrigation was, we can say that that was 12 centimeter. Okay, so for example, if that is wheat, so the wheat total base period is 120 days. Okay, and for example, the see in that example, it was, or it was 1.1 centimeter was the consumptive use of the crops. Okay, so what will be the frequency of irrigation? So that is, for example, 12 centimeter is the water utilization divided by 1.1 is the for day utilization. So approximately we have to apply the irrigation after 10 days. Okay, after 10 days. Now you can see that if the total period is 120 days and we have to apply the irrigation after 10 days, then total 12th irrigation will be applied. Total number of irrigation will be 12, because the total number of days is 120. After 10 days we have to apply the irrigation, then total number of irrigation will be 12. Now, for example, for the first 5 irrigation, you have to apply more than 12 centimeter of water, because that is the maturing stage. And at this stage, the crop is utilizing more water. So, for example, for the first 5 irrigation, you are applying more than the required water. So, that 5 irrigation, will be, you can say that that will be 550 days. And at that 5 irrigation, for example, you are applying 15 centimeter of water in place of 12 centimeter. So, 5 multiplied by 15, that will be 15 centimeter of water will be applied. So that is called the core water, and that number of days is called the you can say that that number of days is called the core period. Okay. Now we have the basic terminologies mostly used in the irrigation, that is the duty and delta. The duty represent the irrigation capacity of a unit water. Okay. For example, if you have one unit water, one unit means 1 cubic meter, for example, 1 cubic meter per second. Okay, so now that 1 cubic meter per second of water is irrigating how much area? Okay, that 1 cubic unit of water, for example, you have 1 cubic of water, so that is irrigating how much hectare? That is called the capacity of the irrigation capacity of unit water, that is called the delta. Okay, it is the relation between the area of a crop irrigated and the quantity of irrigation water required during the entire period of the growth of that crop. Okay, for example, if you have a crop grown in this much area, for example, that is this much hectare area. Okay, now if throughout the season, how much water you have to supply? So if that is Q by A, okay, if that Q is determined in term of unit discharge, mean if that is converted into 1 cubic, so that will be called the duty of irrigation. Okay, for example, in the previous slide we have defined that, for example, in one irrigation we are applying 12 centimeter of water. In one irrigation we are applying the 12 centimeter of water, and total 12 irrigation was required. Now throughout the season total 144 centimeter of water will be required. Okay, now if there is 1 cubic of water supply to the area, if there is 1 cubic mean 1 cubic meter per second of water is supplied throughout the season to supply 144 centimeter of water, so how much area will be irrigated? That is called the duty. It is the total area irrigated by a unit discharge running continuously during the base period, and its unit is area per unit discharge. So that is wrong. We have the hectare per cubic. Okay, in how much area will be irrigated by unit discharge, the area irrigated by unit discharge. Okay, so again it will be depend on the types of soil, it will be depend on the water requirement. Okay, crop water requirement. The duty gives the relationship between the volume of water and the area of the crop which it matures. Okay, mean if you have one unit discharge, so how much area it will irrigate throughout the season? So it will be the duty. For example, if 1 cubic of water is applied to 100 hectare throughout the base period, the duty will be 100 hectare per cubic. Okay. If the base period is B, so if throughout this period, 1 cubic meter per second of water is applied into 100 hectare, then its duty will be 100 hectare per cubic. Similarly, we have another term, that is the delta, mean the total depth of water required by a crop during the entire period of the crop is in the field and is denoted by the symbol delta. As we have discussed in the previous examples, that in one irrigation we are applying the 12 centimeter of water and total 12 irrigation is required. So we can say that throughout the season 144 centimeter of water will be supplied. That is called the delta. Okay. So now see D, that is the duty of the crop. Okay, mean duty of the crop, because if the crop requirement is more, if more water is utilized by the crop, if the consumptive use of the crop is more, then one unit of water will irrigate less area. And if the crop requirement is less, then one unit of water will irrigate more area. So actually duty is related with the crop. So the duty of crop, for example, that is in hectare per cubic, B is the base period, delta is the depth of the water required throughout the season, which is in meter. So now see, if 1 cubic of water is applied for B days, then total volume of water supplied will be, see, if for this much days, one unit of water is supplied, 1 cubic meter per second of water is supplied for B days, so what will be the total volume of water supplied? So volume of water supplied will be B, that is in days, so convert it into second. So in one day there are 24 hour, 60 minute, in 1 hour, 60 second, in 1 second multiplied by 1 cubic meter per second. So that will be the total volume of water supplied in B days if 1 cubic water is continuously applied. Okay, for example, that is equation number one. Similarly, amount of water required to flood 1 hectare of land with a depth of delta C. Throughout the season, this much water is required. So for 1 hectare, how much volume will be required? So area multiplied by depth. So 1 hectare is equal to 10 to the power 4 square meter multiplied by delta. So that is also volume, that per unit area, for 1 hectare area, this much volume of water will be required. And this much water is supplied throughout the season. So compare these two equations. Okay, so if you compare these two equations, then the total depth of water required, see, we can say that B multiplied by this one is equal to 10 to the power 4 multiplied by delta. Okay, so you will get finally this relationship. So it is the relationship between duty and delta. For example, if a crop required this much water throughout the season, and that is the delta of the crop, and that is the base period of the crop. Yeah, we can say that that is the duty of the crop, and that is the base period of the crop. So this much water will be required throughout the season. Okay, that is in SI unit. See, this will be in hectare per cubic, this will be in days, and delta mean duty will be in hectare per cubic, B will be in days, and delta will be in meter. Okay. For example, water is released at the rate of 5 cubic at the head of canal if the duty at the field is 100 cubic meter. Acha, that is the most important factor. Duty at the field means at different point the duty will be different. For example, see here, if that is the field, okay, if that is the field, suppose the field is, the field area is, for example, 5100 hectare. The field area is 5100 hectare. the point where the water is entering into the field, that is called the head of the field. That is called the head of the field. So suppose at this point, the discharge is 3 cubic. So what will be the duty? See, the total area irrigated, divided by the discharge. So that will be 1700. So 1700 is the duty at the head of the field. Clear? Mean at this point the discharge is 3 cubic, the area is 5100 hectare. So the duty at this point is 1700 hectare per cubic. Now suppose this is the water course. So this point, this D point, that is the head of the water course. Now see, if here the discharge is 3 cubic, here it will be not 3 cubic, it will be more than 3 cubic, because some amount will be lost. There will be some conveyance losses. So for example, here the discharge is, 3.1, but the field area is constant, that is, okay. So what will be the duty at the head of water course? See, the duty at the head of the field is equal to 5100 divided by 3 cubic, so it is 1700. Now at this point the discharge is 3.1, so 5100 divided by 3.1, it will be not 1700, it will be less than 1700. Okay, similarly, see, that is the distributary. So at this point the discharge will be not 3.1, the discharge will be, for example, here the discharge is 3.2. there will be greater than this point because there is some losses. So now see, the field area is constant. Now what will be the duty at the head of distributary? So again, 5100 divided by 3.2, it will be less than the duty at this point. Similarly, duty at this point, the duty at the head of the branch, that is the head of canal, that is the head of canal. So see, duty at this point will be less than 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 duty at this point. So at different inlet point, at different heads, the duty will be different. Clear? Okay. Now see, if 5 cubic water is released here, here the discharge is 5 cubic, and the duty at the field is 100 hectare per cubic, mean here the duty is 100 hectare at the head of the field. Okay, and the losses are 30%, mean from this point, from the head of the canal to the head of the field, the losses are 30%. Now find the area of the land that can be irrigated, mean how much area will be irrigated from this water. So see, if 5 cubic is released here, 30% are lost up to here, so how much water will be reached at the head of the field? So if 5 cubic is released at the head of the canal and 30% are lost, so then we can say that 70% of water will be available at the head of the field, yeah, that is equal to 3.5 cubic. Okay, so if 3.5 cubic of water is available at the head of the field, and at the head of the field the duty is 100 hectare per cubic, mean 1 cubic is irrigating 100 hectare, so how much area will be irrigated by 3.5? That will be 350 hectare. Clear? Okay. Find the delta for a crop when its duty is 864 hectare per cubic in the field. See, in the field the base period is 120 days, so we know the relationship. We know the relationship between the delta and duty and base period. Okay, So B is 120 days, delta is 864. So you can see that throughout the season, 1.2 meter of water will be required. If rice require about 10 centimeter depth of water at average interval of 10 days and the crop period is 120 days, find out the delta. See, in one irrigation, we have to apply 10 centimeter of water, and the irrigation is applied after every 10 days and the base period is 120 days. So you can see that in 120 days, if you are applying after each 10 days the irrigation, so total 12 irrigation will be applied, and in one irrigation we are applying 10 centimeter of water, so 120 centimeter of water will be applied, that is delta. Clear? Okay. Similarly, if wheat require 7.5 centimeter of water after every 28 days and the base period for wheat is 140 days, find out the value of the delta. So see, total time is 140 and you are applying the after 28 days of irrigation, so 5 irrigation will be required, and in one irrigation 7.5 centimeter of water is applied, so that is 37.5 of water will be applied throughout the season. Okay, that is the delta. Clear? These are the average approximate values of data for certain crops, like in Pakistan. Okay, for sugar cane throughout the season, this much water is required, for rice, for tobacco, okay, for garden fruits. So these are the deltas of different crops, mean average values. Again, that will be depend on the areas, topography, and other atmospheric conditions. Now, when you are planning water resources project, so first you have to know about the water resources, in the availability of the water, that where the water is available, how much water is available, what is the resource of the water, either it is from surface or either it is from the ground. Okay, then you have to know about the water quantity needed for an area, as we have discussed in the previous part of this lecture, that how much water you are applying in one irrigation, then how water should be applied to the plantation, what will be the mode of application, how the water will be conveyed into the agricultural land, then how the water will be applied into the agricultural land, and what must be the maximum capacity of a canal system. Okay, mean when you are designing a canal, so remember it will be designed maximum requirement throughout the season or throughout the year, because in one field, in one area, we are continuously throughout the year, throughout the season, we are not planting only one crop, I mean there are variation, so some crop will require some crops will have more consumptive use, some crop will have less consumptive use, so the crop water requirement will be different, then the discharge will be different, then the canal capacity will be different. So the canal capacity will be based on the maximum requirement, then which crop is requiring maximum water, so the canal will be designed on that maximum water. Okay, so the following basic information is essential to know about the capacity of the canal system. So almost we have discussed the water resources, the quantity needed for an area, and the application, mean the different modes. Now to find out the canal system, the capacity of the canal system, we have to know about some basic definitions. To know about the capacity of the canal except and duration, first we have the grass commanded area. Okay, so the total area lying between the drainage boundaries of a watershed which can be commanded or irrigated by a canal system. Suppose here we have a canal, and at the downstream of the canal we have this much area. Okay, there will be also, there will be houses, there will be buildings, there will be other farm structures, there will be agricultural land, there will be orchards, there will be other type of plantations, but the total area which is under a canal, that is called the grass, grass commanded area. Okay, in here will be buildings, there will be structures, there will be roads, there will be other types of areas, okay, agricultural land, okay. So the whole area which is under a canal, that is called the grassed commanded area. Now, cultural commanded area, see, as we have discussed, that there will be buildings, there will be structures, there will be farmhouses, okay, and there will be the agricultural land. So only the agricultural land, that is called the cultural commanded area. Again, that is classified into two classes, the cultural cultivated area, mean the area on which crop is grown. See, for example, if this is the total area under a canal, that is called the grass commanded area. Now suppose at this portion there are buildings, okay, these are the buildings. So this area is called the cultural commanded area. Now in this cultural commanded area, suppose only this portion is cultivated, suppose this portion is not cultivated, then it is called the cultural cultivated area, and this area is called the cultural uncultivated area. Remember, some area are not cultivated because we have two seasons. So in one season maybe the crop requirement is more, in another season maybe the crop requirement is less. So in every season we have to leave some area uncultivated so that the crop water requirement in both seasons are kept uniform. Okay. Now, intensity of irrigation is defined as the percentage of cultural commanded area proposed to be irrigated under a crop season or during area. Mean how much area is being, one is the total area, cultivable area. So how much area is cultivated and how much is uncultivated. See, for example, that is the total area, agricultural area. So in one season, for example, this area is cultivated and this is not cultivated. So this area divided by the total area, okay, that is called the intensity of irrigation. Intensity of irrigation means the ratio of area under cultivation to the total cultural area. If this intensity is more area is under cultivation and water requirement will be more automatically. For example, if there is total cultivable area is 120 hectare, in which 90 hectare is cultivated in kharif season and 60 hectare is irrigated in rabi season, the intensity during the kharif season will be, see, 90 is cultivated out of 120, so its intensity will be 75%, and the intensity in rabi season will be, see, 60 hectare is cultivated, so that will be 60 out of 120, that is 50%, and for the total year the intensity will be 75 plus 50%. Okay, now from the agricultural point of view, the year can be divided into two principal cropping season. Actually we have two cropping season, one is the rabi season and the other one is the kharif season. So the rabi season is actually start from 1st October and ends on 31st March, and kharif season start from 1st April and end on 30th September. Okay, these days are not rigid, these are just the average recommendations. Okay, mean the season can be vary from 1 to 2 months. Again, that is depend on the climatic and the atmospheric condition, where sometimes these seasons are variable, these are moving in forward direction or in backward direction. Kharif crops are rice, maize, cotton, and rabi crops are wheat, ground, mustard, etc. Okay, now see, the area which is irrigated in kharif season, mean how much area is irrigated in kharif season and how much area is irrigated in rabi season, its ratio is called kharif rabi ratio. Okay, that is called the kharif rabi ratio, and generally this ratio is kept 1:2, because kharif area is requiring almost more water than the rabi season. Okay, the crop ratio is so selected that, see, now the ratio will be so selected that in both season the discharge in the canal may be maintained uniform. So if you have to maintain uniform discharge in the canal, then you have to cultivate the different areas in both the season. Okay, Then we have the outlet factor. It is defined as the duty at the outlet. Okay, mean as we have the main canal, then we have the branch, then we have the distributary, then we have the water course. So water course is connected at the field. So at this point the duty is called the outlet factor. As we have discussed that the duty is different at different point. So at the head of the field, the duty is called the outlet factor. Okay. Then we have the time factor. So it is the ratio of the number of days the canal is actually run to the number of days of irrigated period. Like if the number of days of irrigation is 15 and canal run for 5 days. See, for example, if the irrigation required for this area is 15 days and the water available in the canal is only for 5 days, then 5 divided by 15 is called the time factor, and the time factor must be 1. Okay, the time factor must be 1 to avoid any difficulties. Then we have the capacity factor. It is the ratio of mean supply to full supply of the canal. For example, if we have a canal, so there will be two capacities, or there will be two discharges. One is the maximum discharge in the canal, okay, and one is the we can say that one is the maximum discharge and one is the average discharge of the canal. So the average discharge divided by the maximum discharge, that is called the capacity factor. Okay, so also we have some other parameters which needs to be discussed, but that is being missed here. Okay, that is we can say that the factors affecting the factors affecting duty. So there are different factors which are affecting the duty. First one is the methods and system of irrigation. Okay. As we have discussed that the duty is actually the capacity of the unit water, that how much area is irrigated by the unit water. So the duty of the irrigation water will be affected by the method and system of irrigation. For example, in the perennial irrigation system, soil is continuously kept moist and hence water required for initial saturation is less, and due to the shallow depth of the water table, deep percolation losses are also less. Okay, so in the inundation irrigation there is wasteful use of water. So hence the perennial irrigation system has more duty than the inundation irrigation. Mean the method of irrigation. For example, if you are applying irrigation throughout the season, so throughout the season the deep percolation losses are less and the soil are already moist, so unit of water are irrigating more area. And in inundation irrigation we are applying more irrigation in flooded form, okay, so it is a wasteful use, so its duty will be less. Okay. And second is the mode of applying water. So see, we have discussed different methods of irrigation like surface, sprinkler and drip irrigation. So the method in which the losses are more, it will have less duty because more water will be lost, in less area will be irrigated. And the method having high efficiency, its duty will be higher. So sprinkler and drip irrigation have higher duty, have more duty, have higher duty than the surface irrigation. Okay. Third factor which is affecting the duty is the method of the cultivation. Okay. If the land is properly cultivated, if the land is properly tilled and made quite loose before irrigation, okay, then the soil will have high retention capacity. Okay, then the soil will have a high infiltration rate, so its duty will be less. okay, in the soil which has less infiltrative, which is not properly tilled, then we can say that the duty will be more, okay. Time and frequency of tilling means if you are tilling the land quickly, okay, in less time, then the infiltration capacity of the soil will be more. The soil will be more loose. More water will be stored in air, and we can say that the duty will be less. Okay. Similarly, we have the type of the crop. Okay. For different crop, if it is utilizing different water, so we can say that its water requirement will be different. Yeah. If its water requirement is different. Then its duty will be also different. Okay. Then also the base period of the crop. So if the base period of the crop is more, the amount of water required will be high, and hence the duty will be low. Okay, because more water will be required. Okay, and hectare per unit discharge. So if more water is required, then the duty will be low. Also the climatic condition, okay, we can say that the climatic conditions of the area, okay, that is also the most important. The climatic condition which affect the duty are suppose temperature, wind, humidity and rainfall. Due to high temperature and high wind, the evaporation losses will be more and duty will be less. A humid atmosphere reduce the evaporation losses. Rainfall during the crop period will reduce the irrigation water requirement and the duty will high. Okay. Similarly, the quality of the water. If the water contain the salts impurities, then we have to apply more water for the unit area. So if more water is applied for the unit area, then the duty will be reduced. Okay. Also the method of assessment of water means what are the method which are charging the water consumption. Okay, so volumetric method of assessment always lead to a higher duty. Okay, mean if water is charged in term of volumetric utilization, then farmers are trying to utilize less water for more area, so the duty will be high. Okay. Similarly, the canal conditions. Okay. If the canal is lined canal, the losses are less. Okay. Then the duty will be high. Okay. The duty will be low. If the canal in an unlined canal, the seepage and percolation losses will be high. So if the losses are high, then more water will irrigate less area because maximum amount of water will be lost. So if more water is irrigating less area, then the duty will be low. Similarly, character of soil and subsoil of the canal, character of soil and subsoil of the irrigation field, these are the different factors which are affecting the duty. Okay, so these are the factors which we have discussed. Now in this third lecture we have discussed the component of irrigation system, the irrigation water quality, and the basic terminologies which are required for the determination of the irrigation water requirement and its measurement. Okay, inshallah in next lecture number 4 we will discuss different methods how to practically measure the irrigation water requirement. Then for each and every crop, how much amount of water will be required. So as we have discussed that if this much amount of water is available, as we have discussed in this lecture, and what is the irrigation water requirement? Okay, so actually that is the consumption use. So you will get the frequency of irrigation. Okay. this is our major concern in next lecture, that how you will measure the consumptive yield, how you will determine the water requirement by different crops. So we will discuss different methods in lecture number 4. Okay, thank you.